today I will be reviewing Venom, Let There Be Carnage. I know that I'm late, but I'm going to review this movie due to Spider-Man No Way Home coming out. And let's begin. So this has spoilers. Okay, let's go. So this is a really funny movie. Like, I've never laughed that hard in the theater in a long time, actually. And this is like a funny movie, and no. This is the movie of the year. It is really that funny, and it does improve upon the first one. And they really knew what to do with this, the second movie. It picks right after the events of the first one, and I really love how their relationship is. And it reminds me of Ren and Stimpy. You know how their relationship would be? How they would always fight around in their apartment? So I really want to see more of their relationship going forward. Okay, so let's talk about Carnage. I was introduced to Carnage in the cartoon series of Spider-Man, the animated series. I, for years, wanted to see him for live action, and it's really good. And people were complaining about how he's not that red, and I think that's the reddest you can get with Carnage. It's like, it looks perfect to me, like how I would do it. I really liked Woody Harrelson. He did a good job. He really acted like a criminal. He did amazing. I was so mad when he was killed off at the end, because I really wanted to see Tom Holland's Spider-Man face off with Carnage and Venom. I really wanted to see that. They shouldn't have kept him, but we don't know. Maybe he'll come back because of all of this multiverse craziness going on. Oh, let's talk about that post-credit scene. That post-credit scene is confusing. Does it start like after Loki, after that event, or does it start after Spider-Man makes that wish? I know that Venom's in a different universe, but I'm just confused. Was it the events after Loki or Spider-Man's wish? Yeah, just tell me. And they really did a good job at that battle. Like, that was amazing. Like, seeing your favorite villain facing off in live action, that was amazing. Again, I really hope that we get to see Venom fight Tom Holland's Spider-Man for a bit. The Spider-Man 3 movie is all crowded. I don't know how he's going to fit into the movie. I really don't. I am excited for the third Spider-Man movie. I'm still trying to stay away from those trailers. Because I really want to be surprised. And I heard that two familiar faces might come show up. So I'm really excited for that. And I think this was a good movie. It was amazing, that's for sure. But I think I would give it a B-.